Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. Summer is here in full swing, and I hope all of you are enjoying the nice weather. The summers in Montreal are not that long, but winters are. So I'm making the most of the nice weather these days. 2 weeks ago, we talked about Tai Chi, the concept, in Tai Chi, the style. Today, we will talk about Tai Chi, the concept in Ba Gua, the style. But first, let's get high on tea. This week's tea is Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong. 2 weeks ago, I introduced Jin Jun Mei tea. In that video, I mentioned that Jin Jun Mei was invented by modifying Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong or Lam Sam Su Chong. Since Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong has an important position in Chinese Hong Cha or Red Tea, categorized as the black tea in the West. I'd like to talk about it in today's video. There are many red teas produced in China with different origins and processing methods. Like anything else, many tea producing regions claim their products to be the oldest red tea with the longest history. However, 中国大百科全书 or Encyclopedia of China says, quote, 世界上最早的红茶由中国明朝时期福建武夷山茶区的汉族茶农发明，名为正山小种 end quote. Translation.The earliest red tea in the world was invented by the Han people in the Wuyi Shan or Wuyi Mountain area in Fujian province in the Ming Dynasty, and the name is Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong. So, officially speaking, the oldest red tea is none than Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong. That's why I said that Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong holds animportant position in the Chinese red tea category. The name Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong consists of four characters. Zheng means central or inner. Shan means mountain. So Zheng Shan indicates the high mountain area or the area of Tongmu Guan, the area believed most suitable for tea growing.Which is about 565 square kilometers or 140,000 acres. Xiao means small, indicating the small tea leaf, and Zhong means species. Put together, Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong means the small leaf tea species growing in the high mountain area. So,any tea produced outside of that area is called Wai Shan Xiao Zhong, or Outer Mountain Small Leaf Species. There are two types of Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong. The first uses smoked by burning Ma Wei Song or Mazen Pine Wood, and the other is unsmoked. Sometimes,In the 18th century, or perhaps even earlier, European traders began to import Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong from China, mostly the smoked variety. The very dark color of the smoked tea leaves might have been one of the reasons it was categorized as black tea in the West. By the way, categorizing tea in China is basednot on the color of the tea leaf, but instead on its processing method. Processing method is a huge and interesting topic in itself, which I will talk about it in the future. The smoking of the tea leaves is an important process carried out in a Qing Lou or Black Tower. These are some photos of a Qing Lou.From the inside as well as outside. So you can figure out how this tea is smoked. By the way, in the old days, 青楼 used to be the term for brothel. Of course, people drink tea in brothels, but to my second-hand knowledge, no brothel produce tea. Traditionally, the tea leaves are smoked early on in the fermentation process so that the tea leaves absorb the pine wood flavor. However, some unethical manufacturers smoke the leaves only in the later stages. As a result, the tea leaf ends up black in color with a pine wood flavor, but drinking this tea will leave a black mark around the lips, which is an indicator of a fake Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong. I have to tell you that the smoked Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong has been mainly targeted for exportation. In China, most people do not drink the smoked variety, so buyer be aware. I prefer unsmoked Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong. In China, red tea is more suitable for the fall and the winter seasons since it is considered a warm tea in terms of health benefits, according to TCM. With fermentation, catechins get converted to theophylline and theobigins, imparting the orange red color and the health benefits to the tea decoction. I have some of both the smoked and the unsmoked Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong at home. This is an unsmoked one, and this is the color of the tea decoction. Very nice bright color along with a nice flavor. To brew Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong, water at 90 to 100 degrees Celsius for 5 seconds is ideal. Add 5 seconds for each subsequent brew. Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong is strong and available in longan, flowery, and other flavors. If it is the smoked kind, then you can notice a strong pine wood fragrance as well. Please try Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong and let me know what you think. Again, if you like red tea, then Zheng Shan Xiao Zhong is a great choice. With that, let's move on to the main topic for today. I have posted two videos about the application of the Liang Yi concept used in Xing Yi and Tai Chi. Today, I'd like to introduce the Tai Chi concept and its application in Ba Gua. In Chinese philosophy, Ba Gua means the eight trigrams, and in martial art, it is a style commonly called Ba Gua Zhang or Ba Gua Palm. In China, typically, people use the term Ba Gua for the martial art style in the spoken context, while they use the term Ba Gua Zhang in a formal written context. Since I'm speaking here, I will use the term Ba Gua instead of Ba Gua Zhang. Topics covered in today's video include, first, Tai Chi, Liang Yi, Ba Gua, and other concepts. Second, the core of Ba Gua practice. Third, practice of Tai Chi in Ba Gua. Fourth, principle of Tai Chi in Ba Gua practice. Fifth, misperception. Sixth, demonstration. Seventh, correction of a student's practice. And eighth, takeaways. So, without any further ado, let's get started. First, Tai Chi, Liang Yi, Ba Gua, and other concepts. I have already introduced Tai Chi, Liang Yi, and Ba Gua in many prior videos, especially in the last two videos in this series. I have explained in detail Wu Ji, 太极 and 两仪 and their applications in the martial arts of 形意 and 八卦。太极、两仪 and 八卦 are philosophical terms describing different stages of the development of any entity in the universe. More specifically, an entity, both tangible and intangible, in the universe starts from 无极, then evolves to 太极、两仪、四象、八卦、sixfold 卦 and so on in its development. If we translate these terms into English, then it becomes non-polarization creates supreme polarization. Supreme polarization creates two principles. Two principles create four forms, and four forms create eight trigrams. Eight trigrams create 64 hexagrams. 64 hexagrams create myriad entities and so on. This is a brief summary of prior videos on these terms. For the rest of this video, any mention of the term 八卦will imply 八卦 the style and not 八卦 the philosophical concept. And any mention of 太极will imply 太极 the concept and not 太极 the style, unless explicitly mentioned otherwise. So, what is the core of 八卦 practice?That brings us to the next topic. Topic 2, the core of 八卦 practice. Owing to the term 八卦 meaning both a philosophical concept and a style, most practitioners unfortunately focus only on 八卦, the concept when practicing 八卦, the style. Of course, it is not a mistake at all. 八卦or 8 trigrams and 64 卦or 64 hexagrams is the fundamental aspect of 八卦, the style. However, if we talk about the core of 八卦 practice, the concept of 太极 is still the most important theoretical foundation that will be used in guiding the practice of the entire style. In other words,太极, the philosophical concept, not the style, guides 八卦 practice. If you want to elevate your 八卦 practice, you absolutely need to understand the concept of 太极 in 八卦 practice. I can't emphasize this enough. 太极, the philosophical concept, forms the core of 八卦 practice, and understanding itwill do wonders to your 八卦 practice. Before going any further, let's first review the concept of 太极. 太极, as explained in some prior videos, is the specific state that connects 无极 and 两仪 in the ancient Chinese philosophical context. In 太极, the martial art,太极 is the stage in which the internal energy starts to move without physical movements. The mind starts to focus on the right place, among other experiences. I highly recommend you watch my video titled Internal Style Concept 52, 太极 Three Stage Theory, 无极、太极and 两仪。In which I have elaborated on the 太极 concept. It will help you have a deeper understanding of this abstract concept. 太极 concept can be directly applied to 八卦 practice. So, understanding the three-state theory will also help you practice 八卦. Recall that I also mentioned thatXing Yi style is based on animal imagery, best illustrated by Liang Yi or the eagle bear imagery. But Tai Chi, the style is not animal imagery based, which means that Tai Chi has its own specific imagery concept, or Tai He Yuan Qi, which I have also explained in a prior video titled Internal Style Concept 45, Tai Chi Imagery, Tai He Yuan Qi. Link is in the description. Now, let's talk about Tai Chi, the concept, in Ba Gua practice. I have mentioned before that movement of Ba Gua is based on Xing Yi, while energy is based on Tai Chi, and walking is based on Ba Gua. Or, 动作行意，尽力太极，走转八卦。However, another translation of this proverb can be, movements are based on 行意, which means the imitation of a natural entity. Power and force are from 太极, or internal changing of energy and stepping follows 八卦, or practice in a constantly changing state. Here, 形意、太极 and 八卦 imply the philosophical terms and not the martial art styles. Both explanations sound correct, but the core of 八卦 practice is best explained using philosophical terms instead of depending on another martial art. So, 太极The core concept of 八卦 practice is the state at which energy is changing and the intent is working before reaching the 两仪 state, a state at which a martial application is executed. 八卦, just like the other two internal styles, focuses on both intent and power generation, which is the result of changes in all the aforementioned energy states, which should be specifically analyzed and practiced in training. This approach is a very advanced topic and critical to any 八卦 practice who wants to reach an advanced level. The focus on internal changes in energy states is also one of the factors that makes 八卦 an internal style. Now, I'd like to mention a couple of quotes from famous practitioners of the style to further emphasize the importance of today's topic. First, from Cheng Tinghua, one of the main disciples of Dong Haichuan and the founder of the Cheng style 八卦, quote, 其实八卦本是一气变化之分，一气者即太极也。一气仍是八卦四象两仪之合，是故太极之外无八卦，八卦两仪四象之外亦无太极也。End quote. Translation: Indeed, 八卦 is the change of one energy. One energy is 太极. 太极 is the integration of 八卦四象 and 两仪。Therefore, there will not be 八卦 without 太极, nor 太极 without 八卦两仪四象. End translation. Here, he clearly stated that 太极 is the integration of other entities including 两仪 and 四象. This is a very abstract part and you may need to revisit it multiple times to fully understand it. Sun Lu Tang, the founder of Sun style Tai Chi and also a renowned Ba Gua practitioner, discussed the Tai Chi concept in his Ba Gua book. He said, quote, 太极之行事者，无疾而生，阴阳之母也。左旋之而为阳，右旋之而为阴。旋转乃一气之流行，太极即一气，一气之太极，以体言则为太极，以用言则为一气。End quote. Translation: As for 太极, it is created by 无极, and 太极 is the mother of yin and yang. Energy turns to the left is named yang, while turning to the right is named yin. Turning is the movement of energy. Tai Chi is also called Yi Qi or One Energy. In other words, Yi Qi or One Energy is Tai Chi. Its essence is Tai Chi and its application is One Energy. End translation. So, according to Sun Lu Tang, Tai Chi in Bagua practice is the One Energy. To summarize, analyzing and understanding the obvious as well as the subtle differences between the state of Wu Ji, Tai Ji, Liang Yi, Si Xiang, Ba Gua, among others, along with their applications in practice, is a key step to reaching an advanced level in Ba Gua practice. So, how should you actually practice Tai Ji in Ba Gua? That brings us to the next topic. 3. Practice of Tai Chi in Ba Gua. To practice the Tai Chi concept in Ba Gua, you have to know that the Tai Chi state connects Wu Ji and Liang Yi. Managing the different levels of extension of Tai Chi toward both Wu Ji and Liang Yi should be the main objective and means to improve Ba Gua practice. To reach this level, every single movement of a routine or form should be analyzed specifically in terms of martial intent and application. It is a time-consuming process, but definitely worth it. It's just like what Cheng Tinghua said, quote, 所以一气八卦为其体,六十四变以及七十二按足互为其用,体意味之用,用意味之体,体用一元,动静一道, end quote. Translation, therefore, Tai Chi is the principle of Ba Gua, while 64 hexagram is its changes, and 72 hidden kicking techniques complement each other mutually as application. End translation. Over the decades, I have observed that many Ba Gua practitioners neglect the opening and closing practices in their training. I introduced this concept in a prior video titled Internal Style Concept 23, Kai He, Opening and Closing. Link is in the description. Paying special attention to Kai He or opening and closing is the key to Tai Chi practice in Ba Gua. Bear in mind, the opening and closing motion is meant not only for physical movements but also for mental activity, especially martial intent. Without the observation of Kai He in terms of martial intent, it would not be considered an internal style. While analyzing every single movement of a form may slow down the quantity of your daily practice, it will actually speed up the improvement in quality of your practice, the result of which will be evident with constant long-term practice. Slow and steady wins the race. Going forward, I recommend you slow down your Ba Gua movements and try to sense the internal energy changes, which is the practice of a Tai Chi state in Ba Gua training. You will only sense the energy internally after you pay attention to your physical movements internally. It is worth noting that Ba Gua is the youngest of the internal styles and still needs a lot of development in terms of its theory and practice. Understanding prior knowledge inherited from prior generations is a good starting point toward that goal. It is especially challenging to understand the Bagua without knowing other styles, since a big part of Bagua content, including theory and forms, was adopted from other styles such as Xing Yi. Having looked at the practice of Tai Chi in Bagua, let's now look at an important principle of Tai Chi in Bagua practice in the next topic. Topic 4. Principle of Tai Chi in Bagua practice. Today, I'd like to introduce one essential principle of Tai Chi in Bagua practice. Bagua Nei Gong Man Zhong Qiu Kuai Zhong Yong. Translation: internal power in Bagua is practiced slowly and applied fast. I created this principle to best emphasize the importance of the Tai Chi concept in Bagua practice. Let me explain. Bagua is an internal style of martial art. Its practice is just like the other two styles in that any movement should be done in slow motion in the beginning and then gradually make the move fast. However, the objectives of the slow and fast approaches are different. Slow movements help to sense the coordination between the different body parts and the internal energy. However, application of the skills gained through slow movement practice should, of course, be very fast. Movements at different speeds provide different benefits to practitioners. So, you should not sacrifice slow motion practice for full speed practice and vice versa. Furthermore, it's even better to practice slow and fast motion approaches in alternation. Also, Liang Yi, as introduced before, also called Yin Yang, is the state in which yin yang energy has been differentiated. In Bagua practice, it is the stage at which martial movement has been executed. For Tai Chi and Liang Yi practice in Bagua training, slow motion is necessary to experience internal energy changes, which is the key objective of this approach. Since I'm introducing the Tai Chi practice of Bagua, I emphasize the slow motion practice. Going forward, remember to focus on this principle in your practice. Topic 5. Misperception. Misperceptions are a common but unwanted byproduct of abstract theory. In today's video, I'd like to clarify a very prevalent misperception about Tai Chi in Bagua practice. When practicing Bagua, especially to someone who has not reached an advanced level, they would focus on learning different forms instead of paying enough attention to some fundamental principles such as Tai Chi theory in Bagua's practice. Their justification is that since Bagua indicates the practice of changes, then practice more forms as many as possible so that more changes can be covered through learning forms. Also, many people expect that theoretical understanding will be naturally discovered and understood with learning more and more forms. It is a misperception. Let me clarify. Yes, Bagua means changes, and the accumulation of the quantitative changes will potentially lead to qualitative change. Learning more forms is a quantitative approach, and it is expected to reach qualitative change. However, a simple accumulation of more forms without carefully and systematically analyzing them will not help you reach the goal. The changes in Bagua are not palm changes. but also changes in internal energy and the martial intent, among other factors. Focusing only on the external changes while ignoring the internal ones is a big mistake in Ba Gua practice. Sure, mere practice of forms with no regard for theory or internal aspects may provide you with all benefit in the distant future, but the ROI will be very low, if any, to begin with. So, mere mechanical learning and the practice of different forms is not a recommended approach. The right approach for a practitioner is to apply current knowledge to analyze their practice and repeat the same approach to refine and deepen existing knowledge, which is very similar to the scientific method. Applying the Tai Chi concept to Ba Gua practice will indeed have a positive impact on your practice. I highly recommend applying this method instead of a mechanical practice. Now, let me show you how to focus on Tai Chi in Ba Gua practice in the next topic. Topic 6, demonstration. Today, I'd like to demonstrate a Ba Gua exercise. It is one of the 64 palms of Cheng style Ba Gua. I will reduce the speed of this practice in order to sense the Tai Chi practice. Okay, now let me demonstrate the same movement in different speed. The first time it's the regular speed. Now, a slow motion speed. Topic 7, correction of students' practice. Okay, now let my students demonstrate one movement, then I will correct his practice. One, two, three, four. So far, good. So now let's start from the beginning. Right, from beginning. Yes. First of all, relax a little bit. Second, the shoulder extend a little bit further. Yes, the first. Let's continue. One, okay. So this movement, the body should sink down a little bit. Contract. Yes. One, yes. And the distance between the feet won't be so much. Just small. Because I turn the direction. Small circle. One, then two, sink down and the right hip relax. Two, and the palm is like this, coordinate toward here. Okay, then turn the chest. Three, yes, and round the back. Then four. Again, now you come back to here, please. Again. So continue. Sink down, extend, relax the right hip, then roll a chest, extend, then one, two, then three. Very good, thank you. Topic 8, takeaways. First, Tai Chi, Liang Yi, and Ba Gua, and the other concept. Tai Chi, Liang Yi, and Ba Gua are philosophical terms describing different stages of the development of any entity in the universe. Chinese martial arts apply this concept in developing internal martial art practice. Two, the Tai Chi concept is the core of Ba Gua practice. Analyzing and understanding the obvious as well as subtle differences between the states of Wu Ji, Tai Chi, Liang Yi, Si Xiang, Ba Gua, among others, along with their application in practice, is the key step to reaching an advanced level in Ba Gua practice. 3. To practice Tai Chi in Ba Gua, you should focus on Kai He and analyze your movements according to the Tai Chi concept. 4. Principle of Tai Chi in Ba Gua practice. Ba Gua Nei Gong Man Zhong Qiu Kuai Zhong Yong. Internal power in Ba Gua is practiced slowly and applied fast. 5. A common misperception is that it's sufficient to merely practice Ba Gua forms without understanding the Tai Chi concept. Remember, that is a misperception and will limit the quality of your practice. Remember to check out the demonstration and the student correction sections to get a better idea of Tai Chi practice in Ba Gua. With that, we conclude today's video. Thank you for watching. See you next time and enjoy your practice.